Well, we're a charity. One, we're a limited company. Two, we're a membership organization. Three, we're a social enterprise. Four, we're a member of the Industrial and Provident Society.
We are an Industrial and Provident Society.
Five. So, and we're an all-island organisation. We operate in Northern Ireland, we operate in the Republic of Ireland, and we have, I think, about 12 people in the organisation. Erskine and a number of other far-sighted people, 13, 14 years ago, Erskine, maybe, give or take, formed UCIT, Ulster Community Investment Trust. It was then primarily a Northern Ireland company. We subsequently road tested our model along the border counties, and now we're very much involved right across the island of Ireland. In fact, the fastest growing component of our business is in the Republic of Ireland. In broad number terms, we have committed £60 million of lending in our history to date. And last year, as it happens, we committed £16.5 million of loan commitments last year. It was our biggest, best year so far. We lend into the community, the voluntary, the social enterprise and charity sectors. I suppose that's the easy bit. And 5 years ago, we won the tender or the contract to manage the Small Business Loan Fund for Invest NI. So that took us into small business as well. It sort of allowed us to spread our wings, our influence into the world of small business. And what money we make there, we channel up into the charity, basically, and we cycle it then into the community and the voluntary and the social enterprise sector. So that is the broad operating model that we try to develop and deliver. I'm a big fan in the community voluntary social enterprise sector of collaborations. I think more and more people are going to have to collaborate to survive. I think they're going to have to show sustainability to survive. These are not nice terms, incidentally. Making a profit sometimes offends the ears here. Well, maybe it doesn't, but I think it's a very worthy thing to generate a profit. I think organizations have to generate a profit. Our organization doesn't maximize its profit, it optimizes its profit. We could make more money quite easily if we chose to do so. We choose not to do so, but we do still make money. Collaborations involve in Northern Ireland. Obviously, I've just mentioned that Invest NI, we collaborate with them in the Small Business Loan Fund. We collaborate with two well-known charities in Northern Ireland as well, Building Change Trust, being one of them, Belfast Charitable Society, the oldest, as I understand it, charity in Northern Ireland, going back to the McCracken family. And last year with Building Change Trust and with Belfast Charitable Society, we formed what was termed the Building Better Futures Fund, which was a £1 million fund. And it was to support organisations right across Northern Ireland, which simply wouldn't have a snowball's chance of getting funding otherwise. And yet, paradoxically, having said that, these are very worthy organisations and they repay their debt, these organisations do. So, but as I say, it was specific to those organisations at the bottom end, so to speak, of the CVSE sector, who, you know, as I say, simply wouldn't have got access to funding. Limited to £25,000 per transaction, and it has worked extraordinarily well. In the Republic of Ireland, we collaborate with the Social Finance Foundation, which is a creation of the crisis in the Republic. It's an organisation that manages or owns the microfinance fund in the Republic of Ireland. It has developed through a number of credit unions. Something of a substitute, maybe we'll discuss this later on, for payday or same day lending, that high cost lending to the most fragile and vulnerable of people in society. But they were put in touch with what added up to, funded through the banks, about €100 million of funding. And there are two organisations in the Republic that distribute that into the community sector, voluntary sector, and that's ourselves and an organisation called Clan Freedom. I don't consider ourselves to be in competition with Clan Freedom. They watch what we do, we watch what they do. But if they're supporting the community sector, they're doing exactly what we want them to do. So collaborations have been very important in the UCIT, Ulster Community Investment Trust, organisation and business. In Northern Ireland, incidentally, we fund all of our lending in Northern Ireland off our own balance sheet. We're not beholden to anyone, we don't report to anybody outside our organisation. All of our money is our own. It wasn't, you know, thus at the very start, when we inherited loans and all of that sort of stuff. But today, we operate our own business in our own way, in a very flexible, supportive, empathic way, we hope, to the community sector. And as I say, we do it, I report to a board of directors, and we do it, as I say, very nimbly, very empathically, very supportively, I hope. But I think, I trust that we deliver an important resource into that sector, which is, again, that community and voluntary sector is facing tougher times at the moment. In just about everybody's view, that has been the case today. Margins are getting tighter, procurement opportunities are growing thinner, government spending is likely to be under some form of stress or another for a number of years to come. The funding cycle has got longer as there is communities and organisations and so on are paid on the basis of outputs rather than inputs, so it's just getting tough. We are thinking at the moment, like in terms of cooperatives, for example, we're perfectly happy to carve out a section of our capital to support, not a massive sum of money, but enough to make a difference, we hope, into the cooperative sector by way of match funding. We're anxious about providing 100% of debt for any project. Any lender's going to tell you that, like, you know, come on, you know, we need, I don't know what you call it, a skin in the game or whatever it might be, a slice of equity, whatever it's called. But in terms of supporting the cooperative and other sectors, our minds are very open. And as I say, we can do by and large what we think is right, what we like, in a way. Okay, point. So, you know, our thinking embraces that sort of approach out into the very near-term future. So that, in a nutshell, is UCIT. I'm perfectly happy now, as I say, there are people in this room that probably know more about UCIT incidentally than I do. But on a day-to-day basis, they give to me the opportunity and the privilege and the pleasure of leading the UCIT team. Thank you very much.